When it comes to space exploration, there's a relatively small window for success and a much larger room for error. However, scientists and astronauts are the best of the best. They have a certain knack for fixing things when they go wrong. Soyuz T-10A. On September 26, 1983, Soyuz T-10A was bound for the USSR Salyut 7 space station, but it never left the launch pad. Before its countdown had even finished, a defective valve released pressurized nitrogen into the fuel pump, causing fuel to leak at the rocket's base. The kerosene caught fire and burned through the shuttle's automatic launch escape system, stopping the program from ejecting the manned capsule to safety. The cosmonauts on board could neither see what was happening, nor could they activate LES on their own. They could only hope that ground control would reach them in time. A backup LES command was given, and the capsule ejected just 4 seconds before the burning rocket exploded. A near miracle, the cosmonauts escaped out of harm's way. While Soyuz 10TA never made it to its planned destination, it could have been much worse. In this case, failure is much better than disaster. Mariner 10. Mariner 10, the first space probe sent to study Mercury, seemed dedicated to behaving like a bratty child. Since its launch in 1973, it constantly malfunctioned and made sure to keep the control team back on Earth on their toes. Among its many problems, giving it timed commands proved difficult as it kept resetting its flight data system. The probe was using an experimental technique of slingshotting itself to Mercury with the help of Venus's gravitational orbit. It was essential for the probe and NASA to know exactly where it was at all times. Otherwise, it could get stuck in Venus's orbit or fling itself out into the cold unknowns of space. Mariner also continuously mixed up the star it navigated by with a bright particle on its camera. A year into its journey, this switch-up happened 10 times a week. While Mariner 10 gave us a lot of invaluable information about both Venus and Mercury, it couldn't take care of itself without NASA holding its hand. Hubble Space Telescope. The Hubble Space Telescope is one of the best and most groundbreaking telescopes the world has seen. Early in its life, however, it didn't have the picture-perfect quality we're used to seeing today. As kids tend to do, it had made a mountain out of a molehill. A small mistake 1/50th the width of a human hair in one of the telescope's mirrors meant that the future of space exploration was hopelessly nearsighted, with the nearest glasses store 340 miles away back on Earth. The pictures it captured were blurry beyond use. What's the point of a $4.7 billion telescope if it can't do the one job it's meant to do? NASA couldn't just bring Hubble down for a little mechanical surgery and a brand new pair of eyes. Help a little less invasive than the agency preferred needed to be brought to the telescope. Two astronauts were sent up to deliver the world's most expensive glasses, the Corrective Optics Space Telescope Axial Replacement. Thankfully, these five pairs of corrective mirror lenses worked, and Hubble's life was saved from becoming a costly failure. Soyuz 18A. On April 5, 1975, the USSR expected to send two of its cosmonauts aboard their Salyut 4 space station for a two-month-long mission. Instead, during launch, the rocket's central core failed to separate on time from the upper stage. When the upper stage ignited, the whole shuttle was thrown dangerously off course, and the launch had to be aborted. Unfortunately, the emergency procedures didn't account for the descent module to be facing down at the Earth when it was deployed. The cosmonauts on board didn't experience an expected 15 G-force fall, but instead a brutal 21.3 Gs. The parachutes deployed correctly, saving those aboard from certain doom, but the danger wasn't over yet. The descent module landed on a mountainous slope and sped down toward a sheer drop. Luckily, their parachute got cut 150 meters from the edge and stopped them from facing an early grave. Liberty 7. In 1961, astronaut Gus Grissom flew the Liberty 7 capsule in suborbital space for 15 minutes during NASA's second manned mission into space before splashing down into the Atlantic. This should be a shut-and-done success. Grissom went up, he saw, he conquered. But a problem in the capsule led the hatch to open prematurely as soon as it hit the water. The capsule began to sink, and Grissom quickly abandoned ship. The astronaut was safely recovered, but Liberty 7 was too heavy for helicopters to lift and quickly became lost to the waves. It wasn't until 38 years later in 1999 that the Liberty 7 capsule was finally recovered from the ocean floor, giving us an in-depth look at what went wrong. Voyager 2. Voyager 2 is the longest-running spacecraft in human history, flying through space with a copy of possibly the most important data in the world, the Golden Record. Yet it almost failed as soon as it launched. While the probe's liftoff went perfectly, it began to panic while strapped to a rocket with no control of its flight. It thought it was failing. The probe's emergency program tried self-assessing the problem and correcting itself, but since nothing was actually wrong, this only made it worse. It turned on and off various controls and kept switching from backup to backup, rendering it incommunicado with Earth, even as controllers back home tried telling it where to go. NASA worried that not only would the probe mutiny, but its twin, the ironically yet-to-be-launched Voyager 1, would do the same when it launched a few weeks later. Luckily, the original programmer was there to re-establish contact a few days after the launch, and Voyager 2, and later 1, ran smoothly from then on. Apollo 12. After the success of Apollo 11, NASA wanted a repeat performance with Apollo 12, except with a more precise landing than its predecessor. While Mission Control was looking up to the stars, they should have been paying more attention planetside. The shuttle launched during a thunderstorm, and 36.5 seconds into its journey, the Saturn rocket carrying it was struck by lightning. Apollo 12 then proved that lightning can strike the same place twice, as 20 seconds later, another bolt of lightning hit the rocket. This wasn't a coincidence, as much as the proverb, "once is chance," likes to say. The shuttle's ionization had triggered the lightning. Lights all around the astronauts' control systems lit up as the shuttle's power overloaded. Telemetry and all three fuel cells shut down. Luckily, one member of Mission Control had seen the same problem happen during a flight simulation. Not the double lightning strike, but the telemetry issues. With this crew member's help, the astronauts aboard reset the SCE system and safely made their way to the moon. Apollo-Soyuz Test Project. In 1975, the American and Russian space agencies launched their first joint mission, the Apollo-Soyuz Test Project, as part of their new détente policy. Three astronauts and two cosmonauts docked their ships together in space, and the two nations shook hands with one another, both symbolically and literally. The mission itself went well, with nothing causing the superpowers to start pointing trigger-happy fingers at each other. When it came time for the two crews to split and come home, however, poisonous gas began to flood the Apollo's cabin. The shuttle ventilation system kicked in, so no one suffered any lasting damage. To be clear, there was no foul play involved, just a little preoccupation on the US's side. The astronauts had forgotten to flip a few important switches for their shuttle's reaction control systems during re-entry. Despite its rough end, the Apollo-Soyuz mission was a success, officially ending the decades-long space race. Apollo 13. 2 days into Apollo 13's infamous journey, one of the shuttle's oxygen tanks exploded, damaging the other in the process. The command module's fuel cells ran on oxygen, and power quickly dropped. The spacecraft's automatic stabilization couldn't fix itself, as many of its jets were now closed shut. Houston, we've had a problem indeed. The crew quickly moved from the command to the unused and undamaged lunar module, turning off all non-essential functions on their way out to conserve power. The LM didn't have the heat shields necessary for re-entry into Earth's atmosphere, but it could be a base to stay alive long enough to come up with a working plan to get them home. The men were stuck in near-freezing temperatures, with most of their food inedible and their water rationed for cooling systems aboard. 4 days after the explosion, the crew returned to the command module for their only shot at making it safely home. It worked. The astronauts splashed down in the Pacific, successful only when it counted most. Have you ever managed to get out of trouble or danger by the skin of your teeth? Though maybe not to the same degree as these space missions and explorers did? I'd love to read your stories in the comments below. 1. Soyuz 5. When Boris Volynov re-entered Earth's atmosphere aboard Soyuz 5 after a successful space rendezvous with another Soyuz craft in January 1969, things didn't go as planned. His descent module couldn't separate itself from the service module, and the combined craft began its nosedive descent without its heat shields at the front to protect it. At almost the last second, the descent module broke from its unwanted partner and righted itself so that the heat shield was finally front and center. Still, the damage was done. The rubber sealing the module's hatch door had burned, and the fumes called Volynov to pass out as they filled the cabin. The parachutes and soft landing rockets malfunctioned, the shuttle crashing to the ground hard enough to break the cosmonauts' teeth. Surprisingly, this failed landing didn't keep Volynov down for too long. Only 7 years later, he went back up into space aboard Soyuz 21.